Every thought that you are thinking, every word that you are speaking, every dream that you are dreaming is shaping your reality. And it is showing up for you every single day, and it is in your face, reminding you that the words you speak, the thoughts you think, have creative power, and they are molding your future. Hello, Shane McLeay here. Thank you for joining me. I want to share with you today the first principle of shamanism, and that is the world is as we think it is. Our thoughts, our words, the energy we broadcast from within are all going out as a vibrational frequency and engaging with the fabric of reality and creating within that existing fabric of reality your reality that intertwines and interweaves with the existing reality. So in effect, you are creating and engaging with the energetic field. You are creating your reality, which is woven into the fabric of the existing reality. And that is what's showing up in your life every day. The world is as you think it is. We live in an ocean of energy where vibrational frequency is responding with the frequencies that we broadcast. This is the law of resonance at work. This is what it's known as. And so what's happening is, as you broadcast a certain frequency, the existing frequencies within the universe come to meet that frequency and then begin to weave that into the fabric of reality. Now, in the shamanic world, we are very conscious about manifestation because the first principle is the manifestation principle. It tells us that the world is as we think it is. So whatever you think, whatever you broadcast, and if we can think around the word think as broadcast, so the world is as you broadcast. What you're broadcasting is what is going to show up because that is the power that you have. And unfortunately, to live in ignorance of this knowledge is to your detriment. And to those who live in the ignorance of the knowledge that what they're broadcasting into the field, it shows up and then they wonder why. But if they really drill down and were honest with themselves, they would see why, because they have created the seeds, they've released them to the energetic field and they have taken root and they have begun to grow. The world is as we think it is. That is a powerful thing, and it is a powerful advantage to those who know. And I'll be very honest with you, and I'm sure you don't need to be an Einstein to figure this bit out. We can't cover this in a 10-minute video, right? I've spent 3 decades learning this, and I can tell you that once you master it, it is a powerful thing. It is a powerful tool that you can use every single day within your life to help you navigate this field, this reality, and to help you manifest the things that you want to see turning up in your life, because you're doing it already. Everybody, everywhere, in every situation is manifesting their reality, whether they are aware of it or not. If you are honest with yourself, you will see that the world that shows up for you is the world where you focus your energetic frequency. Some people will struggle with that because what shows up isn't always good, and taking responsibility for that can be very difficult, right? I've had to do it. Sure, you have. But the more we do it and the more we understand it, the more powerful that principle becomes in helping us shape our reality. So the shaman call this incarnation that we're in the earth walk. So as we walk the earth in this incarnation, we get to experience what it is to be human. It's all part of the experience. It's all part of the journey. And part of the gift that we have, and this lies dormant within the masses, the gift we have is the knowing and the knowledge that as we speak it, as we think it, as we broadcast it, it unfolds. And I know that you know that. And I know that you've seen and experienced that in your own life. It's power. So what we need to do is be mindful around this, and we need to be consciously aware that this is what shows up day in and day out. So what are you saying today? What am I saying today? What am I thinking? What are you thinking? Because these things, these broadcast energies, these broadcast frequencies are going out into the universe and creating reality. The beautiful thing about the first principle is that it reminds us that we don't need to settle for circumstances or situations that show up. The energetic field, the conscious mind of God, the creative source, the creative spirit, whatever you need to call it, is intimately engaged in your life and interested in your life. It's just waiting for you to reciprocate. I want to share something with you that was quite profound. And I wasn't going to include this in this video, but I'm going to. So I mentor a lot of people around the world on a daily basis. And a few weeks back now, I was speaking to, on two separate occasions, to two of my students in the United States. The first person, and they know who they are, the first person, I spoke to them about, we have this bird here in Australia called the bowerbird. And the bowerbird will decorate its nest with blue things, right? And it's a very unique bird, and it has this very unique way of decorating its nest. It will just go and take things that it finds, usually plastic crap. That's, you know, clothes pegs, drink bottle lids, whatever, rubbish that's blue, and decorate its nest. And I spoke to the person that I was speaking to, because this came up in my journey for that person. And we're talking about the need to have laser sharp focus and awareness around what they were embarking on and where the journey was kind of taking them. And so that was all good. I hadn't seen a bowerbird in around 10 years. And I was in a situation where the very same day, within about 3 hours from having this conversation with this student of mine, I saw a bowerbird, and I took a photo and sent it. And the bowerbird was there. It showed up after this journey and after me explaining how that all works. And you might say, well, wow, that was coincidence. Okay, stay with me. So this person has two sessions a week with me. And on the Tuesday, this person told me that without knowing why and without understanding the reasons behind this, she found two blue beads at her back door. And they don't have, she's in the United States, there are no bowerbirds there. And even if there were, you could say the synchronicity between me sharing that with her, then seeing the bowerbird within 3 hours on the other side of the planet, and then within 24 hours, her having these beads turn up on her back step was pretty amazing. So the universe, the creative source, the creative spirit is intimately engaged in what we're doing and what's unfolding for us, right? It doesn't end there. No, we're not even halfway. So what happens then is another student I have in the United States, in her journey, the journey that I went on for her, this turtle energy, this turtle spirit, which is all about nurturing and protecting in the Australian Aboriginal culture anyway, came up, and I was talking to her about that. And she said she had this, since a child, she had this awareness of turtles and that they were significant to her. And it was interesting that they came up in this journey. And so we discussed that. And so then what happened? I was at the beach, and it was the full moon. It was the last full moon in September. And I was sitting up on the beach. I just wanted to be there and watch the moon rise and do some grounding. And I heard a kid yell out, and I was like, ooh, 50 meters away. And I heard a kid yell out, is this yours? And I couldn't actually see what it was, to another kid. And the other kid said, no, it's not mine. So the kid just chucked it back on the ground. And I had this knowing within me, and I said to my partner, I said, that is mine. Whatever that was, it's mine. I need to go and get it. And anyway, so anyone who knows me knows that, man, turquoise and copper, turquoise and copper are very important to me. They're two things that I just love and I cannot get enough of, right? So I walk down onto the beach and you might say, well, this is a coincidence. And I have picked up this turquoise, turquoise bracelet with copper balls as well as turquoise and three turtles. And there were three people in this scenario. There was my two students in the United States and me. And this to me was a powerful gift and a powerful reminder that energy flows where attention goes. That's the third principle. But the world is as we think it is. And I think the universe is constantly conspiring for my good, constantly delivering things that remind me that I am in a place of flow and that amazing and miraculous things can happen. And if the universe, the creative source, the creative spirit, can orchestrate this to have the significance that it had between the three people, the blue beads turning up at my first student's address house, and the turtles showing up at my second student's in her reading, then the bowerbird turning up, the blue beads at the back door of my other student, and the copper and the turtle, because turtle is one of my totems, right? Didn't tell you that. So that's how the universe works. That's how the first principle works. If you want to live in the magic flow of the divine, then get in flow. This is not BS. None of this is just sensationalized hype. This is real. And it's only real to the people who know it. It's only real to the people who understand it. So if you want to sit in the sidelines and be miserable and boo-hoo the energetic flow of the divine, I feel sorry for you. But if you want to get into it and immerse yourself in it, you will live an empowered life, you will live a powerful life, and your manifestations, they will be sweet. Everything in my life and your life is a manifestation. But when you get to the point of being able to determine what shows up and when, that's powerful. And for me, the manifestations in my life become clearer, more detailed, more concise, and more in flow every single day. It is like magic, it is powerful, and I would invite you to press in and learn this stuff. Apply it to your life. We're about to launch a whole bunch of courses on shamanism and how those principles can help you. So if you're interested, stick your details below or shoot me an email, whatever you need to do. We'll put you on the list, let you know when those courses are coming out. And we're gonna be doing some free ones because energy flows where attention goes. So I want to give it out of abundance so that abundance keeps flowing, because that's a principle. Thank you so much. This is real. This happened. I've got witnesses. I got my two students in the US and the people that were with me. My partner was with me when I found this, and she was like not surprised, because for her, this stuff is a normal daily occurrence, right? Remember who you are. Step into your power. Talk soon.